Hello students, good morning. Today we will start our new chapter, that is pronouns. You have studied this chapter in lower classes also, so it will be easy for you to understand. So let's start. First we will discuss what is pronouns. Pronoun is a part of speech which functions as a replacement for noun, noun phrase or noun clause. You can say that pronoun is a word which is used to avoid the repetition of the noun. Again and again we are using the noun. So in the place of noun, we will use a pronoun to avoid the repetition. For example, I, it, he, she, my, all these words are known as pronoun. Now we will discuss the types of pronouns. Mainly, there are 9 types of pronouns. First, personal pronouns, possessive, interrogative, reflexive, emphatic, demonstrative, distributive, relative, and indefinite. Okay, we will discuss one by one these type of pronouns. So, let's start with the first type, that is personal pronoun. The word personal, what does personal means? Personal means hamari, jo hamare liye use ho rahi ho, that types of word is known as personal pronoun. So we can define it as a pronoun that refers to a particular person or a group or thing. Here the word which is used for a particular person or a thing is known as personal pronoun. For example, I, me, my, us, these words are known as personal pronoun. Clear? Up to now, we have studied that personal pronoun only. But now, we will differentiate that personal pronoun are of 2 types. Subject pronoun and object pronoun. Now, what is this subject pronoun? It is defined as a pronoun that acts as a subject of the sentence. Okay? You all know that a sentence is having a subject and an object. Then only it becomes a complete sentence. So, the pronoun, the word which is acting as a subject in the sentence, that is known as subject pronoun. I would like to go to the party. Here, what is the subject? I. But I is also a pronoun. So, the pronoun which is acting as a subject in the sentence, that becomes the subject personal pronoun. Okay, whom we are talking about. He left office early today. Who left? He. So, he is a subject, but he is a pronoun also. So, this becomes a person. Subject personal pronoun. So the pronoun which act as a subject in the sentence is known as subject personal pronoun. The second one is the objective personal pronoun. Again, the pronoun that act as an object in the sentence becomes an objective personal pronoun or object personal pronoun. It is defined as a pronoun that act as an object of a verb, compound verb, preposition or indefinite phrase. She praised me for a job done well. So, who praised me? She. So, she is a subject. So, it becomes a subject personal pronoun. And whom she is praising? Me. So, I am acting as an object. So, I becomes an object personal pronoun. Clear? Simple, subject nikala, that becomes a subject personal pronoun and object becomes an object personal pronoun. Clear? So, personal pronoun is of 2 types, subject personal pronoun and object personal pronoun. Here, personal pronoun, in this we are having 3 person. First person, second person, third person. Here I have given you the table. Later on I will discuss what is personal, first person, second person and third person. Here is the table in which you can use the personal pronoun accordingly. If it is a singular or a plural, male or a female, so you have to remember this table. Clear? For first person, I and me. For second person, you, you. For third person, he, him, she, her, it, it. Like this, you have to remember. So what is first person? First person means I. Jo baat kar raha hai, who is the speaker? It is defined as a pronoun that refers to the speaker or writer or to a group that includes the speaker or writer. That means the main person who is telling something, who is writing something, that becomes the first person. I, me, we. It can be a singular or a plural. Okay. Second person, who is receiving? Who is receiving this first person's writing or something? It is defined as a pronoun that refers to the person with whom one speaks. Main kisse baat kar rahi hu? Aap se. Okay. Who is receiving me? You. So that becomes the second person and it is always, always you or yours. Clear? First, who is delivering, who is speaking, who is writing, and second, who is receiving that speaking or writing is known as second person. Now, third, ab to do aamne saamne. The third means to whom we are talking about, jo at present picture mein nahi hai. It is defined as a pronoun that refers to people or thing other than the speaker and the listener or addresser person. Okay, hum dono ke alawa jo teesra hota hai, that is known as third person. And we identify the third person as he, she, her, it, they. Clear? So we are having three person, first person, second person, third. First is the speaker, second is the receiver, and third who is not present in the picture. Clear? Now, the second pronoun, that is the possessive pronoun. Now, student, possessive means, simple meaning of possessive means belongs to, show the possession, wo kisko belong karti hai. So, we use possessive pronouns to refer to a specific person, people, thing or things to whom it belongs to. And something belonging to an animal, animal's thing. That book belongs to me. That means that is my book. Okay, that belongs to. Possessive pronoun are written without apostrophe. Humko ek dimag mein hai ki possession show karna hai, to we are using apostrophe S. No. When a word is acting as a possessive pronoun, we will never use apostrophe S. We will just write, for example, yours sincerely. We will not use apostrophe because here yours is acting as a possessive pronoun. Clear? Possessive pronoun generally comes at the end of the sentence and no noun is put after them. Clear? It's is not a possessive pronoun. Hum hamesha confuse ho jate hain ki it's is a possessive pronoun, but it is not a possessive pronoun. It is possessive adjective, so it is followed by the noun. I told you just now that it is generally comes at the end of the sentence and no noun is put. For example, in this, the dog hurts its paw. Paw is a noun. So it is acting as a possessive adjective. It is not acting as a possessive pronoun. Clear? Possessive pronoun show the possession. The pronoun that show the possession is known as possessive pronoun. Here is the table. The word used for first person and second person, for singular and plural. Clear? You can learn it. Now comes the interrogative pronoun. That is very easy, interrogative. How you will define? The pronoun which is asking a question is known as interrogative pronoun. Clear? We use interrogative pronoun to ask question. The interrogative pronoun represent the thing that we don't know. Okay. The word which is asking a question becomes a interrogative pronoun. And mainly there are four interrogative pronouns. Who, whom, what, which. Agar sentence mein ye word aate hain and they are asking a question, then it becomes a interrogative pronoun. For example, who told you? Whom did you tell? What's happened? This all becomes an interrogative pronoun. Now, the most toughest pronoun, reflexive pronoun. Actually, there are two types, reflexive and emphatic. They are mostly the same type of pronoun, but there are little difference between them and the children usually get confused between them. So, listen it carefully. I will tell you two or three such points according that you can easily identify whether it is reflexive pronoun or emphatic pronoun. Firstly, the word which are having self is known as reflexive or emphatic pronoun. Pronoun ke saath self hoega, to wo reflexive banenge. Clear? Pronoun in which the action of the subject reflects back to the subject itself is called reflexive. Little difficult. In easy word, when the action and the object reflects the same person, action or object bhi same person ko reflects karta hai, so it becomes the reflexive pronoun. Clear? Hua thoda sa clear? When the action of the subject reflects upon the doer, then it becomes a reflexive pronoun, or we can say the subject and object refers to the same person is known as reflexive pronoun. Clear? The main difference is if reflexive pronoun is removed from the sentence, it won't make a complete sense. For example, I hurt myself. Here myself is reflexive pronoun. Okay? If we will remove this myself, then it will becomes I hurt. So that means any sense to the sentence? No, it is incomplete sense and it does not make any sense. So we can keep in mind ki if we will remove the reflexive pronoun from the sentence, it will not make any sense. Okay. It is used after the verb. The reflexive pronoun is used after the verb. So to identify the reflexive pronoun, first identify the verb, or verb ke baad pronoun hai self wala, to it become a reflexive pronoun. So reflexive pronoun always come after the verb. For example, they can help themselves. Themself is reflexive, or wo kiske baad aaya? Help. Help is a verb. So you have to keep only three things in mind. First of all, it reflects the when the subject and object reflects the same person, or you can say it reflects the subject and object to the same person. When the reflexive pronoun is removed from the sentence, it doesn't make a sense, and reflexive pronoun is always come after the verb. Okay, now I will talk about emphatic, then it will be clear. It is defined as a pronoun that emphasizes on a noun or another pronoun. Emphasize on a noun, on a subject. Okay. In it, the action cannot be used as the subject. In that, the action can be used as the subject, but here the action cannot be used as the subject. First different. Second, if the emphatic pronoun is removed from the sentence, then it will not affect the meaning of the sentence. In that, it will affect the meaning of the sentence, and here it will not affect the meaning of the sentence. She herself cooked food. Who cooked food?
she herself. And if we will remove this herself from the sentence, then what will become? She cooked the food. It means the same. Usne khud ne khana banaya. Usne khana banaya. So when we will remove the emphatic pronoun from the sentence, it will not affect the sentence. Then it will come after the person or a thing. Whereas the reflexive pronoun comes after the verb, whereas emphatic pronouns come after a person or a thing. For example, they themselves completed the work. So, themselves is emphatic pronoun because it is coming after they. They is a person. Clear? So, student, please keep these 3 points in your mind, and then it is very easy for you to understand whether it is a reflexive or emphatic. First, in that the action and the subject and the object reflects to the same person. Here, it is not like that. Second, if the reflexive pronoun is removed from the sentence, it doesn't make any sense. And if emphatic is removed from the sentence, it will not affect the meaning of the sentence. Reflexive come after the verb, whereas emphatic come after the person or a thing. Clear? Now, demonstrative pronoun. It is also very easy. It is defined as a pronoun that point to a particular noun or to the noun it replaces. That means when we are talking about a particular noun, we are demonstrating about a particular noun, it becomes a demonstrative pronoun. It points the object, particular object. For example, she gifted me that pen. Which pen? That pen. So we are talking about that particular that. Thick. Here is a table I have given these doors. If a object is near or a thing is near, we will use this and these in the singular and plural form, that and those in the farer form. So here I have given one diagram also with this you can understand. Distributive pronoun. Distributive means distribute karna, distribute the chocolate. Okay, so here when we are talking about a particular group, and us group mein hum particular persons ke bare mein baat kar rahe, means collectively we are talking. So distributive pronoun are those which show that person or thing are taken one at a time or in a separate group. Okay. Suppose I am talking about the 8th standard. Whole class I am talking. But I am saying each one of you, each student of 8th standard. So collectively I am talking about each and every student, but in general I am talking about the class. Okay. Each refer to two or more person taken one by one. Either means one or the other. Neither is of course the negative of either. Okay. And this pronoun is always used in a singular way. I am talking about the class, but I am talking singularly about each of the student. Okay. Few words are there which are used as a distributive property. Each, either, neither. Each is used for the positive form and neither is used for the negative form. Clear? Neither of your answer is correct. Many students are sitting together. Aur ek saath mujhe sabko bolna hai, toh I told neither of yours. That means I have address to each and every student present there. That is known as distributive pronoun. Clear? Relative pronoun. Relative means to showing the relation. So here, where we are showing the relation? We are showing some relation between the sentences.
Okay, a relative pronoun is a pronoun that join two sentences. We are showing the relation between the two sentences. We are joining the two sentences and refer back to noun going before them. Okay, it is known as relative pronoun. Mostly we are having five relative pronouns: who, whom, whose, which, that. Clear? But student, these words are used in the interrogative pronoun also. So you can say, madam, they are interrogative pronoun. So never get confused between interrogative pronoun and relative pronoun, as words are same but the meaning is different. If a pronoun is asking you a question, who is your teacher? That I am asking a teacher, then it becomes an interrogative pronoun. But if I am showing a relation between the two sentence, joining the two sentence, then it becomes a relative pronoun. I met Ramesh. Who stood first in the class? Here I am not asking a question, but I am creating a relation between the Ramesh whom I met. Clear? So these words, if they are asking a question, then it becomes an interrogative pronoun. But if they are showing the relation, then it becomes a relative pronoun. Clear? Words are same. They are used as interrogative pronoun also, and they are used as relative pronoun also. Who is used as a subject? Whom is used as a object? Whose is shows for the position? Which is used for a thing? That can be used for the people, thing, together. Okay? Relative pronoun can refer to singular or plural, and there is no difference between male and female. For both, we are using the same word. The person who phoned me last night is my teacher. Okay? Here it is not showing you the gender. Okay? Few examples are also there. Clear? Now, the last pronoun, that is indefinite pronoun. Here we don't know anything. That means we are not referring to any particular person, place or thing. That becomes the indefinite pronoun. Hame pakka unke bare mein kuch nahi pata hai. So, aise word, ऐसे pronouns को we called as indefinite pronoun. An indefinite pronoun does not refers to any specific person, thing or amount. Okay, when we are not talking about some specific particular person, they are called as indefinite pronoun. Some typical indefinite pronouns are as follows. Means these words are used as indefinite pronouns: anybody, nobody, I don't know, everything, you want something, nothing. So nothing, I don't know, मुझे उसके बारे में कुछ नहीं पता. So at this, उनको हम बोलते हैं indefinite pronouns. Clear? So some people are born great. Whom we are talking? I don't know, but I generally told some. Okay, all are dancing on floor. I don't know who are dancing, but few are dancing, so I called all are dancing at the floor. Clear? Somebody has stolen my book. Who stole my book? I don't know, but somebody has stolen. That I am not definite about who has stolen. So at that time we are using these all words which are given in the table, singular and plural form. Clear? So these are 9 types of pronouns which I have explained you in this chapter. I hope you understand it very nicely. Go through again and again. If you are having any doubt, you will be clear. And if you are having any doubt, let me know through the comment box. I will definitely clear your doubts. I hope you like my video, the style I teach you. Thank you, student. Have a nice time. Good day. Bye.